in the previous recorded lecture, we discussed the definition of globalization. We can define globalization differently, but one thing stands out. That is, globalization is a process that is oftentimes related to world economy. In this recorded lecture, our focus is on the characteristics of globalization or katangian ng globalization. The characteristic is integration. After World War II, countries are more convinced that there are problems that transcend national borders, which basically means the effects of a problem in one country can reach other nations. For instance, COVID-19. We all knew that this originated in China, but at present, there is no untouched continent in the world that does not have COVID-19. Another example is a terrorist attack in Saudi. It can be a localized attack, but the effects on oil prices will be felt by countries relying on oil. With this and other concerns, countries need to work together to provide solutions to problems. Thus, integration occurs. By integration, we mean countries or nation states begin to establish a stronger relationship and to create organizations for an increased collaboration. International organizations were created to speed up response to international concerns. By international organizations, we mean three or more countries forming a group voluntarily. Governments of these nation states chose representatives who will act on behalf of the leaders to come up with common position and common solution to a problem affecting the groups. International organizations, or IOs, can be classified into International Governmental Organizations, IGOs, and International Non-Governmental Organizations, or INGOs. INGOs can be further classified as a global IGO or global IGOs and regional IGOs. To help you understand the difference, we will be using examples. So, among the most popular global IGOs are the United Nations, World Bank, International Monetary Fund, and of course, World Trade Organization. Membership to these organizations is almost universal, which means almost all countries are members of these organizations. The second classification of IGOs are called or is called regional IGOs. For example, Association of Southeast Asian Nations, the European Union, Organization of Islamic Countries, and others. Membership to this type of organization is exclusive to a specific region. The second characteristic of globalization is called delocalization. So prior to globalization, products and other services were locally produced and required workers to work on site. With an increase in delocalization, products and other services are now carried out abroad and sold somewhere else. For example, a molten basketball, that particular basketball may be made from China or the Philippines, but sold somewhere else. Another example is a property in America. This property may be sold by someone in a call center who is in India or in the Philippines. Because of delocalization, new practices were in place to increase productivity and, of course, profit. So, what are these practices? The first practice is called outsourcing, which basically means we avail of the services of people from other companies with payment. The purpose is to lighten the burden of working so that people can work on more important matters and activities. Now, an example of this outsourcing, let's take a look at Quezon Science High School. So we have the teachers and some non-teaching personnel. So the teachers are tasked to provide you with learning experiences. Now, as a school, we need to be secured. Now, imagine if the teachers will be the one to secure the place. Okay, we put additional burden to their work, and they might not be able to do their function of teaching and of providing security. Thus, what we do is we avail of the services of other people from other companies. And of course, with these services, the school also provides payment. Outsourcing can be classified into what is being outsourced, and then the other one is where is the service outsourced. So for what is outsourced, there are basically two: business process outsourcing, which means contracting services in relation to operation by a third party service provider. So in this includes accounts payable, customer call center relations, document management, human resource, payroll, and social media marketing. The second one is called knowledge process outsourcing, or KPO. The focus is primarily on research and development, patent development, applications, market research, and others. So there are countries that are popular for BPOs and KPOs. For BPOs, we have the Philippines and India. For KPOs, we have India, Sri Lanka, Eastern Europe, Poland, Romania, and the Baltic states. Now, the second classification is based on where is the service outsourced. And we have different types of this. Okay, so in this illustration, you will see that there is Nike Air in United States, and there is another company in the Philippines where businesses for Nike Air or Nike Air is being conducted or are conducted, and we call this as offshoring or relocation of operating activities to another country. For instance, the manufacture of, let's say, t-shirts may be done in the Philippines, which is of course away or miles away from the United States. This is called again offshoring. The second type of outsourcing based on where the business or where is the services outsourced is nearshoring. Now in this case, outsourcing of BPs or business processes to nearby countries. In this case, United States, it can be in Canada or in Mexico. Now, if the services are rendered within the same country, we call this as onshoring. Now, which basically means domestic outsourcing, where BP or services are rendered by a company from within the country to limit expenses. Of course, it will be more expensive to do offshoring. Now, basically, it all depends on the state of the economy where you would want to outsource your services. The third characteristic of globalization is the rise of multinational corporations or transnational corporations. So there has been a growth of corporations in the past years. And these multinational corporations are businesses that have facilities and other assets in at least one country other than its home country. So the parent country, so where the business originated, let's say in the United States, and then another company or facility in the Philippines. So a multinational company generally has offices and or factories in different countries and a centralized head office where they coordinate global management. Again, they choose countries where to put or to extend their services based on whether it's cheaper, whether they will be more profit when they put up a business center or business in another country. Again, multinational corporations or MNCs are non-state actors together with non-governmental organization. The last characteristic of globalization is technological advances, mobility, and faster delivery of products and services. By mobility, we mean here, people can now freely move from one country to another at low cost and much faster speed. With the invention of modern transportation, products and services can now easily reach its destination with little cost. Technological advances means the improvement that we see in terms of technology, and of course technology is more encompassing and it can include communication. Before, we only rely on airmail. Nowadays, we can communicate with videos. This can make management of companies abroad even easier. So basically, because of technological advances, which again is more encompassing, mobility and faster delivery of products and services, through technological advances, which is more encompassing, mobility and faster delivery of products and services with little cost become possible. So those are the characteristics of globalization. In the next video, we will be talking about the enablers of globalization.